Hello. Welcome to how to turn a TP-Link router into a network storage server by connecting to traditional hard drives. Here is the router and traditional hard drive I used in this example. Requires a router with at least one USB port. At the end of the video I will show you how to connect multiple hard drives to a single USB port. To connect a hard drive to a router, you will need an adapter. If you are using a traditional hard drive, you should use an adapter with power. I will leave it in the description for easy reference. The router cannot format the hard drive, so you still need a computer to do this. You use the adapter to connect the hard drive to the computer via USB. Your computer will detect the hard drive and you create one or more partitions on it. Here I delete all the old partitions and create only one new partition on it. After you have finished creating the partition, you connect the hard drive to the router line. You use a phone or computer connected to the router using a cable or wireless. I recommend you use a computer connected to the router. You can access the device management page using the IP address or domain name. The domain name is printed on the device. If you cannot access using the domain name, then you search for the gateway address and use it to remotely access the router. After successfully logging in, you go to Advanced Settings. There you go to Storage Device Management. The router automatically detects the hard drive connected to it. By default, the router automatically enables sharing mode in the local network. I use a computer to access the shared folder over the network. You can use the IP address or use the name of the device. I use both ways to access the shared resource. I will create a new file to ensure folder access. I recommend you enable secure folder sharing. I create a new password for it. It is possible you need to restart your computer to apply the security changes. You will be asked to enter a username and password to access the shared folder. The router also supports external access. You access the management page and allow access from the internet. By default, the device does not allow external access. I access using the external IP address of the router. My router connects to the internet via a modem, so I continue to set up as follows. Instead of using dynamic address mode, I set the device to static IP address mode, so the external IP address of the device does not change. On the modem, I forward port 21 to the external address of the router. I check to make sure the port forwarding is successful. After the port forwarding is successful, I access the shared folder using the public IP address. I was able to connect to the remote network storage server, but the public IP address can change, so I use a dynamic domain name service. You just register a free account to use the dynamic domain name service on the router. On the router, I log into the account that was registered before. Next, I register a dynamic domain name. This dynamic domain name helps you update the public IP address. You will not lose connection to the file server if the public IP address changes if using a domain name. These are the basic steps to use the router as a network storage server. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. As mentioned, I will guide you how to connect multiple hard drives to the router at the same time with just a single USB port. Instead of connecting the hard drive directly to the router, I use a USB hub. Just add it, you can connect multiple hard drives to the router. On the management page, you will see the device detects multiple hard drives connected to it. That way you can increase the capacity of the network storage server. Good luck.